are first on the program. My name is Tamara Witkin, and my partner here is Michael Carpolo. And the first pieces on the program are by Robert Schumann, and they were written for younger and elder children. And we are just excerpting four from the collection. And one of the four is called Trower. And we chose that piece specifically for Sylvia because she has lost her partner of 18 years. And so this piece is called Mourning Music, not mourning as in the morning, but mourning as in sadness. So that's the second piece from the collection of four that we've chosen to do. The pieces were written in 1848, and Schumann had yet 9 years to live. So this is coming at towards the end of his life. And he didn't live past the ages of, 48, 49, something like that. Didn't even make it to 50. And he had already had 9 children with his beloved Clara, who was a good 12 years younger than he. And these pieces kind of recall the happier times when he played hide and seek and when he told ghost stories to his children and wonderful memories. So you'll hear playfulness, you'll hear tenderness, and a real communication between the primo and the secundo part. So without that dialogue, there would be no successful conveyance of this music. So this is a wonderful ensemble piece. And also by this point, Schumann had mastered all the forms of classical music. He had written symphonies, he had written chamber music, he had written songs, and in fact, the first 2 years of his marriage, he literally burst into song, writing 300 songs. And he had written, at this point, even operatic music. So this piece of chamber music also brings forth that vocal quality that he had developed so beautifully. Enjoy.
Thank you.
might need a page turner for this. Do we have any volunteers for a page turner? Olga, can you come up here? I'll have you stand on the left here.
Thank you. Grieg's dates are 1843 to 1907, so he was like 13 when Schumann died, but he was known as a lyrical miniaturist and a major romantic composer. He made an impact on wide European audiences, and so he was very popular. But he was indebted to Swedish influence because he was Norwegian, but Sweden owned Norway from 1814 to 1905, so that included his years. And so his reputation was made by his piano concerto, the piano concerto in A minor, the one everybody likes. And Liszt was very impressed by it, and he loved it, and he even sight-read it the first time he saw it. So, and okay, so Grieg died at age 64. Liszt helped Grieg with the orchestration of the piano concerto, so he had a lot of influences. And these Norwegian dances, well, the last one we're going to play is from Peer Gynt, written in 1888. So he was 45 when he wrote this. And so when he died, there were 30 to 40,000 people at his funeral, showing how he was so loved.
And as opposed to Schumann, now Schumann's concerto and Grieg's concerto are often on flip sides of the record or the CD, because they're so compatible with one another and similar in style. This is more like a march, right?
Thank you.
the most famous. It's Anitra's Dance from Peer Gynt.